close to 1,000 runs in the hot and humid conditions of Colombo and Sri Lanka in 97, India's tour of Sri Lanka. India was made to field for 3 days. Sri Lanka scored 952 for 6 in the second innings, India's response of 500 plus runs. There are some test matches, as a viewer, you would like to forget, and that was one test match. But at the same time, the test match also made me to ask questions as a young kid. In the late 90s, who started watching cricket, to ask questions why it was so difficult to win in Sri Lanka. That test match, along with India's first test defeat against Sri Lanka in 2015, followed by India's comeback in that series and winning 2-1, made me pick India's tour of Sri Lanka as the best series India played in the year 2015 ahead of the World Cup. It was a close contest, but I went ahead with India's tour of Sri Lanka because of these two reasons. Hello friends, welcome back to Wrong One. India had toured Sri Lanka on 6 occasions in the past, and they had not tasted success on many occasions, barring the 93 visit where India had won the series. This time around, too, in 2015, India was touring Sri Lanka for a 3-test match series and had 1 or 2 challenges too. India had a slightly inexperienced captain in terms of Virat Kohli. Second, they had 2 to 3 new faces in the team, and the batting position with regard to where do they bat was a challenge. And third, they had lost Mahendra Singh Dhoni not only as a captain but also as a calm influencer in the team, as a cool finisher in the test team in the lower middle order. India was heading with quite a few challenges. After being in a comfortable position to win the first test match, India went on to lose the first test match. India were chasing 186 and were 34-1 in the last innings of the match and were scheduled out for 112. India lost a great opportunity to start a series on a winning note. But what happened after that, India came back and won the series 2-1, being 1-0 behind, made me pick this series as the best series India played in that year. India, for the first time, I could happily say that in the past 10-15 years, while touring, has played well as a unit together. India has played well together as a unit, as a team. All the players performed, all their players chipped in with runs, wickets, and all-rounders coming in with runs was something really significant. The role models in terms of Ajinkya Rahane and Cheteshwar Pujara went on to score good centuries in the second and third test match. The inexperienced player like KL Rahul, Stuart Binney went on to score runs as well as pick wickets. The all-rounders, in fact, I'm happy to add Amit Mishra to that role in the all-rounder. Ravichandran Ashwin and Amit Mishra went on to score good runs in third test match, and the bowling was led by the experienced Ishant Sharma and Ravichandran Ashwin. Ishant Sharma performing in flat wickets in Sri Lanka was something really, really prominent. But in fact, the third test match was slightly conducive for the fast bowlers, and Ishant did well in the third test match too. India had performed really well as a team, as a unit, and that was a happy sight for me. And I picked that series because of one of those reasons. And Virat Kohli had started his test series as a captain on a winning note. Virat showed it to the world that he meant business. After that, Virat went on to win a slew of test series in home as well as while touring. And that was the beginning of Virat Kohli's captaincy. I hope you guys liked our video. This was our best series of the year in 2015. We have got the best series of the year in 2010 to 2014, and this was 2015. Hope you guys like our content. Kindly give your feedback through through comments in the below section. Like our content, share our content, and support us in this journey and help us grow. Thank you.